transform the degraded into horn of abundance, allowing and assisting farmers to transform significant areas, like one third of all already degenerated agricultural lands, into carbon agroforests, would remove so much carbon dioxide from the atmosphere that levels would stop rising and possibly would soon would become less than pre-industrial levels, and this long before certain of the time objectives of any of the UN climate change COPs. Precise calculations of the above carbon dioxide removal and its timeline are the subject of other videos in this channel. No financing is needed. No financing is needed to achieve this, quite on the contrary. Solving it all while thriving would provide many new jobs and make old and new industries thrive. Yet it would not need or depend on financing, other than the because of massive returns to be expected voluntary investments of also return-oriented private persons, companies, and industries. Landowners and tenants start the initiative and invite and propose to investors and industry. Landowners, tenants, and also or maybe especially carers like indigenous groups with rights, should unite as a group and make business proposals to return-oriented private persons, companies, and industries, including to CEOs and industries that also are able to produce, provide the software to operate, and if requested for or necessary also operate the needed range of lightweight robots that will be needed to harvest the unprecedented 100 times higher production of renewable and organic products and services, and this without tilling soils and without heavy and soil compacting machines. Horn of Abundance. The landowners, tenants, and carers should be aware and convince investors and industry that their carbon agroforest initiative on sufficient scale will make the investors and industry, and in fact all 8 billion humans, thrive, simply because they will provide all what all 8 billion humans need and consume. And that includes food, fuels, renewable hydrocarbons, energy and basic materials. Ranging from bulk materials, including metals, to sophisticated and extremely expensive materials like graphene, silicon, and rare earth metals. A more complete list with materials and services, as well as some of the processes to obtain the above list of materials, are the subject of other videos of this channel. Humans are not unable to solve all challenges and thrive. They are just unaware. Humans need to stop thinking that they, trees and forests, are unable to solve all challenges, plus or rather consequentially make all humans thrive, because history and NASA research and NASA videos extensively prove they can. This is the subject of other videos of this channel. Humans need to stop thinking that they need politicians, that they need someone or something to pay to solve their challenges. It provingly never worked this way. Activists and certifications. Landowners, tenants, and also or maybe especially carers like indigenous groups with rights, should unite as a group and invite activists to learn about carbon agroforests and their proposal, and show the importance of the activists to unite and campaign for certification of the carbon agroforests' many organic and renewable products. Carbon agroforests provingly are a multiple whammy in the removal of carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere, and nobody would be able to make that stop. Carbon agroforests accumulate carbon in the trees, forest, and vegetation, and even more in their deep accumulating and darkening and eventually self-regenerating soils. Ancient Amazon amarins provingly did so for thousands of years, and their surprising and enigmatic results are recently known by modern scientists and research as Amazon Dark Earth or Terra Preta, and can still be found in the Amazon forest and are estimated to be present or have been present in 4% of the Amazon forest. Please remember that the Amazon forest is roughly the size of the continental USA or Europe. In carbon agroforests, such a system of trees, vegetation, and soils absorb on a 12-hour base all carbon dioxide in all of the atmosphere above it, and above the whole continent, and in fact the whole southern hemisphere. The green flickering in the NASA video on your screen graphically represents the daily total removal of all local and incoming carbon dioxide. It just does not sink in because we 8 billion humans are blind to this beneficial natural system and its hemispherical and global importance and potential. Most probably people that are not blind block it out as being too good to be true. But it happens and works every day like clockwork. It is this clockwork that you see as green flickering. Except one flicker is not a second, but a day. Since it is aligned to the sun, and since NASA satellites make snapshot maps every so many hours, you see it as a stepwise east to west movement. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. With 1 and 2 being roughly the 12 hours that the sun does not shine over the forest and vegetation, when moving away after sunset from the west coast of South America across the globe, until it moves closer and rises again over South America coming from the east, again activating photosynthesis across South America, this from the east coast to the west coast. All day long, carbon dioxide from the rest of the world, including or rather dominantly from the northern hemisphere, will accumulate at levels under the carbon dioxide level presented in this video, and consequently not visible in this video. To make this low and invisible carbon dioxide accumulation visible, NASA inserts the green cones that will form the green flicker, this only so in the southern hemisphere. NASA does not insert the green cones in the northern hemisphere, because the northern hemisphere is already engulfed by the, in the presentation clearly visible, high carbon dioxide level accumulations. These green cones become flicker simply because during the day and with the ongoing photosynthesis the forests and vegetation will absorb what these additional for visibility inserted green cones represent, which are low and thus here invisible accumulations of carbon dioxide. So what really unfolds before your eyes is that forests and vegetation absorb all massively from the rest of the world incoming carbon dioxide, including that constantly incoming from the northern hemisphere, this by normal weather systems, but also the very fast jet streams that proceed and transport high carbon dioxide accumulations directly from the northern hemisphere, at speeds of medium 200 km per hour or much more. So what also unfolds before your eyes is that forests and vegetation absorb all the by them during the night released carbon dioxide. As you all know very well, normally living forests and vegetation do not present any netto release of carbon dioxide. So what they release at night, and also absorb during the day, is characterized by the cones as coming from forests and vegetation, is in fact the during day and night massively incoming carbon dioxide from the rest of the world. While during the day and night massively incoming fossil fuel carbon dioxide from the rest of the world, and most of all from the northern hemisphere, it is by NASA recharacterized as being from vegetation. This while it clearly first came from fossil fuel burning and emissions and accumulations that massively and violently came from the northern hemisphere. This way the northern hemisphere and the so-called developed world keep on living in the illusion that the southern hemisphere also has or has its own accumulation, or even has a unique and possibly worse kind of carbon dioxide accumulation related to practices characterized as typical of the southern hemisphere. This is indeed an illusion and untrue, because the southern hemisphere has no accumulation, and at the point it has it comes totally and massively from the northern hemisphere. If the accumulation that indeed occurs at some point in time would really be from the southern hemisphere, it would be visible as green, and that is not the case at all. Supposed emissions of forests like the Amazon forest as well as vegetation are not originated from vegetation. So the statement that this invisible fraction that is artificially made visible with green cones, and in the NASA video presented green, and if it were from the forests and vegetation is not at all from forests and vegetation, but instead from the rest of the world. If the South American forests and vegetation would be netto emitters, the southern hemisphere would present more accumulation than the northern hemisphere, and not relative absence of accumulation which it presents, and which you see the absence of on your screen, this in relation to the presented level of carbon dioxide, and this in relation to the northern hemisphere, and that you can observe in this, as well as in other related NASA videos. Unedited potential. Human activities release approximately 35 to 40 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide annually, with the most recent estimates for 2024 around 37 to 38 billion tons. Carbon dioxide concentrations have increased from a pre-industrial level of about 280 ppm to over 419 ppm in 2023. 1 part per million, ppm, of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is equivalent to approximately 7.82 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide. This figure is calculated based on the mass of the atmosphere and the volumetric concentration of carbon dioxide. 1 ton of carbon dioxide produced during combustion corresponds to approximately 270 to 360 kilograms of hydrocarbon fuel burned, depending on the specific type of fuel. When the process is reversed by means of carbon agroforest plus sunshine, 3 tons of carbon dioxide roughly can render 1 metric ton of fuel. Roughly 140 ppm of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere originated from industry, and is equivalent to approximately 7.82 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide. 1,040 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide, or 346 billion metric tons of fuel. The world produces approximately 2 billion metric tons of motor gasoline and diesel oil annually. This figure represents the combined production of both gasoline and diesel, with road fuels like gasoline being the most used oil products. In other words, carbon agroforests are able to remove from the atmosphere sufficient carbon dioxide to produce for free, meaning paying nothing at all for the resources, both gasoline and diesel, to foresee all humans for roughly 170 years. This would be superior, cleaner and more effective fuel, no to confuse with ethanol, that on top would be a renewable fuel, because it would have been taken out of the atmosphere quite some time, before it would be emitted once more, that from the moment it would be burned, like for instance in ICE motors, or to support or in fact provide for all the electrical grids of the world during peak hours, or in fact continuously if this need would exist. And now the second most real big thing, if the fuel would be burned, which it probably would fully replace all fossil fuels that otherwise would be used for motor gasoline and diesel oil. And now possibly the most real big thing, for this purpose only one of 170 parts, so roughly 0.5% of the carbon agroforest potential would have to be used for this purpose. So the other 169 parts or over 99% of the carbon agroforest potential could and would be used to produce all that 8 billion humans need, this apart from motor gasoline and diesel oil. That could and probably would include all of the more advanced materials like graphene, silicon, rare metals, and rare earth metals, that all would be produced infinitively in this sustainable infinite manner, by means of carbon agroforests and sunshine. In case you like action over empty promises, and the here proposed initiative or action plan, for either solutions for climate challenges, or for humans to thrive like never before, or a carbon agroforest world, and carbon agroforest employment and economy, or like the quite unique information in this video, please subscribe to this channel, leave a comment, question, or a like on this video.
Oui.
This and other videos of this channel are translated and or dubbed in over 5 languages, including the official languages of all 9 Amazon forest countries, this for this initiative and plan to succeed, to unite all 8 billion humans across the world, in and through this carbon agroforest action plan, and economy.